Okay, so now we're going to need to go into Supabase. So click on this. We're going to need a new credential. And it's asking for our role secret. So we're going to go to supabase.com. All right, start your project. Sign up. So, all right, so now that we're in Supabase, we're going to need to get that URL and that API key. All right, so scroll down here. This is going to be your project URL, so hit copy. Go back to n8n, paste. Service role secret. You will go to view API settings and hit that. API keys here on the left, service role secret. Reveal, copy. Service role secret, paste, save. Okay, done, perfect. So that's done. No thanks. So that looks good. Now, this is going to use the same thing, so we'll go ahead and load that up. That's fine, we'll update that later. So Google, same thing, right? Yep, that's good. This one, same thing. Yep. So next thing that we need to do is we need to create a database in Supabase. So the way that we do that is you're going to need to get the file from my school community, and it's going to be called Supabase SQL editor code. So go ahead and click on that to open that up. Now that you're in, hit Control A, Control C to copy. Go back into Supabase and then go over here on the left and click SQL editor. New SQL snippet. You're gonna see this code editor, hit Control V to copy to paste and hit run. That's basically gonna help us create a data table that's gonna help us to put the data in. So now we're gonna go to table editor. And as you can see, there should be one created. It's going to be called knowledge base. So now we need to go back and select it. So here, double click on this and then choose the table. So it's gonna be called knowledge base. Same thing over here, choose the table, knowledge base. Knowledge base. So actually it's saying that we need to use our function, which is called match documents. Go back over to that over here and put match documents. Over here, match documents. Go ahead and click on execute workflow over here. So now it's going to go through and successful. So it should have updated the information here. So I'm just gonna refresh that. And yep, that's correct. So it created two different chunks of information. So that's perfect. So now that the workflow is active, just call the phone number.
Hello, this is Amanda from Apex Agent Systems. How may I help you today?
What is the company name?
The company name is Apex Agent Systems. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
What is the purpose?
The purpose of Apex Agent Systems is to help businesses increase revenue with custom AI voice agents and to teach students how to profit by building and selling them. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
To show you also that you can actually update it whenever you want. So this will actually automatically update it. So if we update our database, so let's say the company name is, I don't know, Ajax Agent Systems, okay? Then it'll actually automatically update it. So we can go to our database over here and watch that it automatically updates. And as you can see, it automatically got updated. So that's perfect. So that is it. I just showed you the step-by-step tutorial of how to build a Vapi RAG agent that automatically updates itself based on the information that you gave it in the Google document for your company information. So make sure you subscribe, because the next video that I'm going to make is going to be an even more mind-blowing AI agent. So I'll see you in the next video.